Hello boss babes and bosses out there. So in this video, I'm going to teach you on how to build your portfolio even if you still have zero experience or even if wala pa kayong client. So if you want to learn how to do that, just keep on watching. Sa video na to, may dalawa tayong parts. The first part is that I will share to you kung ano yung dapat nyong gawin kung nagbibuild kayo ng portfolio. And the second part is kung ano yung hindi nyo dapat gawin if you are building a portfolio. So if you're okay with that, let's dive in. So the first thing that you can do if you are still enhancing, if you are still improving your skills, if you are watching tutorials, either it's for free or paid, always apply it on your own. Like, try mo talaga siya and then screenshot mo yung mga ginawa mo. Screenshot mo yung outcomes, screenshot mo yung results, or maybe do a screen recording while you are practicing it, while you are still familiarizing that software or that tool or that app. Screen record your screen and then after that, you can upload that sa mga online storage platforms like, for example, Google Drive or maybe OneDrive or maybe Dropbox, yung mga ganun. Marami pang mga online storage na mga platforms, but those three are the major platforms that I know. Ito sila yung pwede kayong mag-upload ng mga files na pwede yung isend kay client if ever magtanong si client na, hey, have you tried using this tool or app or software? And you can say, yes, I've already tried that and I'm already familiar with it. Here's my progress or here's the screen recording that I have while I'm doing that, while I'm familiarizing the tool or software that you have just said. So you can just send the link sa recorded screen mo or maybe meron kang screen chat, yun yung isend mo sa kanya. So that's a plus point and you can use that as part of your portfolio. So the next one is that if you are attending masterclass or trainings, paid or free, you can ask your coach or mentor for their feedback. Okay, so for example, wala siyang hands-on training, like walang actual na training sa inyo, like masterclass lang talaga, like they are just lecturing the whole time. It's okay, but maybe you can ask for certificate na magbibigay proof na sumali kayo sa masterclass. And that certificate or maybe their feedback na makuha mo sa kanila, you can put that as testimonial from your coach or mentor. So you can save, maybe you can screenshot. If it's certificate, maybe they can send to you by hard copy or soft copy. If that is a soft copy, you can just download it and then save it to your drive. So the third tip that I'm going to share with you to build your portfolio online is to show up on your social media accounts. It depends sa'yo kung gusto mo ba sa Facebook or gusto mo ba mag-focus sa LinkedIn or maybe sa Instagram. Those three platforms are my really go-to when it comes to building portfolio online, especially when it comes to social media portfolio. So those three are really good to use when it comes to portfolios. You can share there about your services, you can share there about your processes, about how you are helping your target clients, just something that can help other people. Any content na magbibigay impact sa ibang tao, it's really a good content. And the more kasi they can see that your content are so helpful for them, mas madali yung makukuha yung trust nila. And by that, it's easier for you to convert a sale. Just be yourself when you are showing up online. The more authentic you are, mas maraming tao ang mas makaka-connect sa iyo. So, that's one of the top secrets when it comes to showing up online and creating your portfolio using social media platforms. So, maybe you're asking now, okay, so I want to start creating my online portfolio using social media accounts, but I really don't know how to create graphics. I'm not an artist. I'm not that so creative. I also don't know how to put captions. Basically, I just don't know where to start. Even what content to put, I don't know kung ano yung mas magandang content na ilagay online. Don't worry, I got you guys. We just launched our first digital product ng BossedUp PH. Ito yung 31-day minimalist template. We already provided the 31 topics that you can share to your social media accounts. We also provided the minimalist templates that is for feed and including na yung for stories. But not just that, kasi may caption template na tayo na pwede nyong sundan para alam nyo kung ano yung isi-share nyo sa topic na yon. So, we also have a caption template and we also have a suggested hashtags if you want to use Instagram for your posting. So, pwede yung gamitin yung mga suggested hashtags na nilagay namin. So, yeah, I can really say na it will really help you practice your social media management skills, yung pag-create ng content online and pag-show up online. Not just that again, because you can use this for your clients as well. So, for example, you have a client and you still don't know pa ano yung graphics na gagamitin nyo, tapos you still also don't know the topics and you still don't know the hashtags. Everything is already provided na sa aming first digital product, which is this one. So, if you want to avail the product, just message BossedUp PH so that makakuha kayo ng discount. By the way, the discount for BossedUp Farm is up until November 17 na lang. So, hope you guys makagrab pa kayo sa discounted na price para happy ang lahat. So, yeah. I would highly encourage you to avail that kung gusto niyo mag-show up every day. Pero ang problema niyo is hindi kayo marunong masyado sa graphics and you still don't know what content to post and kung paano gawin yung captions, ano yung isasabihin niyo sa captions, and ano yung mga gagamitin niyo na hashtags. So, it's really complete. Try to browse our Instagram accounts here. Ito yung mga sumali din sa campaign. You can try to browse their page then so that you can see kung ano yung mga ginagawa namin and how they are using the templates na pinurchase din nila sa amin. So, hope that is clear. But if you still have further questions, please feel free to message us sa Facebook page namin, BossedUp PH. So, for the fourth tip that I'm going to share with you is to look for beta or task clients na pwede nyong maging portfolio yung output niya. So, when I say task client or beta client, this is basically a client na you work for them for free or in a discounted rate. So, this is where you can test your skills talaga. This is really one of the best ways that you can build your portfolio. Yung meron ka talagang test client or beta client. Kasi aside from doing really the work, meron talagang feedback from a real client. So, the more kasi makakuha tayo ng feedback from a real client, mas alam natin kung ano yung dapat natin gawin sa project natin or sa work na yan. All of their feedback, good or bad, always take note of it. So, if the feedback is good, you can publish that sa social media accounts mo as a social proof so that other people or other prospect clients can see that you have a good results sa mga previous mo na mga clients. But if the feedback is, you know, something that you can improve pa, hindi siya necessary na i-upload mo sa social media mo. But always take note of that and always make sure that you can improve that aspect na sinabi ni client para the next client i-handle mo, mas may maganda ka ng feedback na ma-receive sa kanya at magawa mo siya as a social proof. And also, don't forget din na anything na gagawin mo for your beta clients or for your task clients na gawin mo siya as portfolio. But ask their permission first if okay lang ba na gawin mo yung portfolio ang mga nagawa mo para sa kanya. And if it's okay sa client mo, you can ask a video recommendation because that is also a good social proof. Ang ibang mga clients din, may inganyo din sila to work with you kasi they can see a video talaga from your client recommending you na magaling ka, na expert ka sa service mo. So the last one but not the least that I'm going to share with you on how you can build your portfolio online is that to create even just a simple website. To be honest, it's not really necessary. You can still launch projects even if wala ka pang website. You just have to send a link maybe sa Google Drive mo or OneDrive mo or any links na doon mo sinestore lahat ng mga social proof mo, lahat ng mga sample mo sa work mo. Yes, you can still learn that. But you know what? Mas makukuha mo yung trust nila if they can see a website na pwede nilang makita lahat ng mga gawa mo, lahat ng testimonials from your clients, and how to contact you, and ano yung process mo. So by that, you can easily get their trust. So I have a video here. Even very beginners or mga non-tech savvy people can follow this tutorial. It is an easy way for you to build a site using Google Site. So there are a lot of platforms that you can build a website, but I guess this one is the very, very easy na way on how you can create your own. And then one thing I like dun sa Google Site is that mobile friendly siya, nag-a-adjust siya sa mobile. Ang iba kasing platform, hindi siya masyadong mobile friendly. You still have to install something para maging mobile friendly lang siya. And then maybe you still have to set pa the mobile view. It's just a lot of work. This one, Google Site, automatic siya, nag-a-adjust sa mobile. So those are the things that you can try. Do it for yourself so that you can build your own portfolio. But guys, I want you to know that meron din kayong dapat hindi gawin if you want to try to build your own portfolio. First is to not use other work para maging portfolio mo. That's a no-no. You are just grabbing their work and putting it as your own na parang ikaw ang mawa para maging portfolio mo. That's a no-no. Kasi, you know what ba magkakaproblema ka lang yan? Kung ikaw na yung gagawa, eh, hindi the same yung result. So, makikita yan ni client at magkakaproblema ka lang. So, we don't want that to happen. Just do your own portfolio. Practice your craft para mas maganda yung maipakita mo na portfolio kay client and mas hindi ka pa magkakaproblema. So, that's a no-no. So, the second one that I don't want you to do is to create a fake testimonials. Do not create fake testimonials. If wala pa talaga kayong testimonials na makuha, wag muna kayong maglagay. Mga sample of your work, sample of your output, yan lang muna yung ipakita nyo. Pero kung meron na kayong feedback na nakuha, maybe sa mentor nyo or maybe sa coach nyo, kung wala pa kayong client, that's already good. You can use that as part of the testimonial. But please, huwag talagang gumawa ng fake testimonials kasi it will just hurt your business. We don't want to lie to our clients. That is a no-no talaga. Anything na mga unethical, just don't do it kasi mawawala yung blessings. Imbis na dadami sana yung clients mo if you are just going to do the hard work, if you are just going to be persistent and dedicated sa mga ginagawa mo, dami sana ng mga upcoming clients, but then you are also doing some unethical, mawawala siya. So please, I would highly encourage you na do everything the right way. The very general tip I can give to you if you are now trying to build your own portfolio is that while building your portfolio, try to apply na din ng mga jobs, try to communicate with prospect clients, try to pitch your service sa kanila. Huwag ka nang mag-intay na maging super, super bongga yung portfolio mo. You can build your portfolio while you are still looking for clients. So, yeah, that's my main tip. If you are still trying to build your own portfolio, please also look for prospect clients na. So, hope that this video gives you an idea on how to create your portfolio and ano yung mga hindi dapat yung gawin. So, before I'm going to end this video, I would like to flex the works of my boss babes and bosses inside my group. Check this out! Want to join our Facebook group, just research I'm ready. It's Boss Up by Brooke Sui, and don't forget to like our Facebook page at Boss Up PH and follow us on our Instagram account at Brooke Sui and at Boss Up PH. And yeah, if you have any further questions with regards to the 31-day template that we have, just message us on our Facebook page at Boss Up PH. Hope to see you guys on my next one. Bye!